All right, welcome back everyone. Today we're in my 2015 A3 again, and we're changing the steering wheel. So I have the non-sport, non-flat steering wheel and no paddles. So what we are going to, as I got this bad boy used, this is an RS7 flat bottom steering wheel out of a similar era. You can see the wheel buttons are the same. Super excited. This has the really cool OEM shifters that are a little bit taller. Some of the most basic ones are just like flat and black. So this should be a swap for swap. So I'm gonna do like one long shot with this and then just edit out the dead time. See here, see those holes? Those are where the springs for the airbag hold the airbag onto the steering wheel. So something we can do before we get started, actually, let's 245. That way we'll be honest. What you wanna do? Park on some cardboard. And then when you need to turn your wheel, super easy. Okay. Good enough. Okay, see, with the key still inserted, I'm gonna turn the wheel halfway. Just for fun, these light up red. I don't know what the other wheel will be. Grab your 10 millimeter. And what you want to do is you want to make sure you tuck it good. That way it can't pop off and fly over and make contact. It's pretty hard to set off an airbag, but if you do set off an airbag, it will not be pleasant. Set this on selfie mode. So you can see, I'm using my camera on selfie mode to locate the spring. I can see it. Okay, instead of trying to attack it flat, turn your screwdriver like this. Okay, you can see I have the steering wheel popped out. Once you get the first one, the second one comes pretty easy. So what you're doing is on the back side, the spring that hooks around this, instead of trying to pry like that, I had better luck just pushing it down, and while pushing it down with this, I was pulling on it with the other, on the airbag with the other side, and it popped off. So now we have two connectors. Hopefully you can see this. That just pops off. And this one, there's a white centerpiece. Okay. So this connector is basically just kind of a press on. You just hold one side, pull the other. This connector, if you have really fat fingers, use a 90 degree pick. You pull this out, and then it allows the yellow clip to release. Okay, found my set. This is an M12. Cool. Not all of them, but on this one, there's a mark on the steering wheel and there's a mark on the shaft. Some of them don't always have the mark on the shaft. That's kind of nice. So with this one, new steering wheel also has a mark. So we're good to go. Pretty excited about this, guys. Just for fun's sake, if we hold this up, a little bit shorter, give me an extra inch. Oh man, that just popped right off there. It's the joys of a not 40-year-old car, you know what I mean? Make sure your clock spring does not spin from where it originally was. Okay, so I got some lining up to do. I don't know if you can see that, but the clock spring is in place. The lines are lined up. Clock spring is sticking through those two holes. Airbag connectors there. You could add some more Loctite if you want. I'm not going to. Ooh, this is fancy. One thing at a time, we're going to connect the little controls harness first and then the airbag harness second. There's a little square there, a little metal piece sticks into that so you know you're good. And it goes brown purple to brown purple. Wires are color different. It'll probably work. Okay, steering wheel's clicked in place. I gotta clean up the airbag, it's a little dirty, but that's neither here nor there. Okay, if a loud bang happens, it's gonna scare the crap out of me. Interesting. I apologize, car. Oh, I left my signal on. Okay, those light up red. Oh, yes. The paddles light up as well. That is cool. I like the money shot. So now I have a flat bottom steering wheel. I kind of want to go check out the paddles, see how they do. That's it, though. What time is it? I started at 2:42, 3:01. 3:07. So, you know, with filming and everything, 12:42 to 3:07, I'd say that's not too bad. Realistically, if you're not recording this, you could probably do this in 10 minutes. You know, even if you've never done it. Super easy. All right, thanks for watching. All right, what's up, everyone? I'm out on a cruise, out on a little test drive in my old neighborhood, out in the boondocks. I'm happy to report the shifters work perfectly. Probably one of my favorite parts of the shifters is normally when you want to go into manual mode, you gotta push that over there and go up or down, whichever way you want. Now with this, you just see I'm in drive. I don't know if you can see that, but just tap the paddle, boom, right in manual mode. And what's cool is when you're in manual mode, I mean, I'll probably hardly ever use them, but I have them and they look cool. When you're slowing down, normally my car would be like 4, 3, 2, 1, you're gonna slow down. And manual, it slows you down a lot slower. And then, watch this, if I come to a complete stop, it puts it right back in drive. That way you don't take off and you're not redlining your gears, you know? So, I really like that feature about it. I mean, that's technically a stock TCU trait, but if you keep it stock when you get your TCU tune, it'll stay that way. This is an EQT, I don't wanna say what stage TCU tune, I don't know. It matches my stage 2 tune. And this is an A3, so you know, stock IS20, big deal. But just something cool to note. And if you shift up too quick, let's say I put it in sixth, and I'm going 40, like an idiot, you know, let's say I'm lugging it, it'll put you back in drive. It'll throw you back in drive and be like, hey, don't destroy your engine. So I really like that feature. I'm pretty happy with it. So anyways, I appreciate everyone watching, your likes, your comments, everything. Be kind to each other.